So let's move on from this microtransaction ordeal, and let's talk about something more, I guess, more sad than even people, kids spending $3,000 on their parents' credit cards and, you know, putting their family in debt and having them file for bankruptcy over a video game. Even worse than that, especially China, there is a video game addiction crisis.
Yeah.
There's so many stories out there. Of the most recent one from last week, there was this kid. I don't even know if he was a kid. I think he was around our age, like in his maybe early 20s or late teens.
He's a kid. He's a kid.
Yeah, I mean, still pretty young person.
Yeah.
You know how China, the way most people play their games is through internet cafes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this guy was sitting at an internet cafe. He was playing the game for 20 hours straight. And you know how when you're in the middle of a game, like you're sitting down, or if you sit, just in general, it doesn't even have to be video games, when you sit in a weird spot and then, you know, your leg or your foot falls asleep. We've all obviously had that experience before. You know what happens if you ignore that and don't walk it off, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can become paralyzed. They might have to amputate your fucking legs. Well, this guy, he ignored it. He played for 20 hours straight with his legs numb, didn't move, didn't get up, and they put him out, they dragged him out of there, and he had no feelings in his legs, but he was more worried about having to leave his game than not having feeling in his legs when he was dragged out, and he is going to be in a wheelchair now. So, and
oh,
this isn't
God.
Even the worst of it, though. There are people who actually die during gaming sessions. Like, there was one that, they thought, you know, another situation in China with the internet cafe, there was one that was just playing the game nonstop, and then they thought he fell asleep, but he was actually dead. He was playing for, like, over a day straight. And a lot of the times, because, you know, if you're sitting down the entire time, you know, that's really bad for your heart, because there's no blood flow. So there's just so many sad stories. There's an even sadder story of two parents that neglected their child and he starved to death because they were too busy playing an online game together. China and Korea, those countries specifically, I mean, I'm talking about South Korea, obviously. North Korea doesn't have any video games.
Yeah.
But China and South Korea, I don't really hear too much of it in Japan. I mean, they like video games, but I don't think they have a crisis. But for some reason, China and South Korea just have crazy video game addiction problem. Like, you know, with here, you hear about microtransactions and, you know, that kind of thing. But you don't really hear about people dying playing video games. I mean, actually, I did hear at one time, there was actually a big YouTuber that had like 500,000 subscribers. He was doing a 24-hour stream and he died in the middle of it.
Oh, crap.
Well, he didn't die like on camera. What happened was that he actually went to take a break. But he actually had a heart attack because he was playing for so long. So if you ever, I know Barry, you like to do your live streams, you know, every Saturday or whatever.
Yeah.
You do like to play a lot. Do not play for too long because, you know, you might end up being like these guys.
Right. Yeah. I mean, okay, so I have this series on YouTube called Strange Stories in Gaming. And I can't tell you how many of them, like maybe even over... maybe even over like half of them are stories of people falling over and dying or, and I heard that story the other day of the guy becoming paralyzed, and just dying because of this video game addiction. And it's insane. People actually hate it when you call it video game addiction because it's internet addiction. But like when you're addicted to something, you're addicted to something. And that is just too far.
Yeah.
But you're totally right, and that's actually something that I do think about quite often. I mean, my job now is YouTube.
Oh, wow.
When I was working at Falcon, I would stand up and build computers all day. Or I could stand up and sit down. But now that I do YouTube full time, I sit a lot. And it kind of gets on my mind sometimes where I'm like, I do need to get up and move around, because if I don't, I'm like gonna half my life. I don't know if you've like there's this couple articles about sitting.
Oh yeah,
you wouldn't realize how dangerous it.
I think a lot of it is sensationalist. I mean, you know, they say if you sit, like sitting down for 1 minute is like two cigarettes or something.
No,
I think that's ridiculous.
No, bull crap. No, but the article did say that from all the time that you sit, if you just take a day sitting, you can never work that back. You know, like when you put on like 8 pounds, right? You can just start sprinting, start jogging, get on ellipticals and stuff, and you can work it off. But apparently, when you sit, the damage that it does cause cannot be reversed.
And what damage is that?
It's typically just you're more prone to heart failure. You're more prone to sporadic sleep. You're more prone to diabetes, I think.
So if you cannot, if you actually cannot walk, like you're in a wheelchair, every minute you're spending in that wheelchair is like awful.
Oh, yeah.
Like it's bad enough not being able to walk, but if you're just sitting because you have to sit, it's not your fault. Wow, that
yeah,
sucks.
No,
I mean, I've heard
fault.
About that before, but I feel like a lot of it, I mean, they're just trying to sell you these, you know, these standing desks and all these products, you know, it's just,
yeah.
I feel like it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like, so by that meaning though, like by that, with those studies, that means if you just going to sleep is bad for you.
Well, what they were saying was like, even look 100 or 200 years ago, the only reason people would sit was either to take a break from their work, because they were working in fields all day. They were farmers. Everyone was a farmer or a marketer. So the only reason you would sit down is to take a break or to sleep. Everyone was always up. This was never an issue before. But people are at least theorizing that a lot of the reasons that we have so many health problems recently is because we spend more time at a sit-down job.
Yeah.
And this leads to more issues. Things that we didn't have before.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like they want you to go. I still think, like, standing all the time probably isn't good for you either. If you're just standing the entire day, like, it's got to exhaust you and it's got to have some problems too. I can't imagine, like, you've seen those poor people who have no customers, you know, who work a retail job and just have to stand for 8 hours straight.
Oh, dude, that was me. Yes.
I mean, that's got to be not good for you either. I mean, do you feel good standing up the whole time?
No, it does not feel good.
Sitting feels pretty
but
good.
But then again, neither does exercise. Exercise is good for you.
Yeah, I guess. But I feel like they don't, I don't know. I don't believe a lot of this shit because one day it's one thing and the next day it's another. Like, you know, everything causes cancer now. Everything is this, everything is that. You can call me a skeptic or a conspiracy theorist. I'm not really a conspiracy theorist. There might be some validity to a lot of these studies. I just feel like they exaggerate it way too much for article clicks or something. Because, you know, if you see an article that says sitting down kills you, you know you're going to click on that shit.
Yeah.
So
which could totally have its own merits. But one thing that is a real issue is getting addicted to sitting down all day. Oh my God. So my father, okay. So my father listens to the radio. He told me this the other day. They do this segment where people can call in and complain about their wife or their kids or their husband, whatever. And this guy calls in and he goes, I went into my son's room. He's 24 years old. He will not get a job, right? All he does is sit at home and play video games, right?
Mm-hmm.
I go into his room and I was like, hey, get up. You're getting a job. Get up, get washed, put some good clothes on, and get out and find a job. You need a job. We're not paying for you anymore. And he goes, Dad, leave me alone. I don't want to get a job. You know what? I want a job. Leave me alone. And he's like, you're not sitting at home playing video games anymore. You're going and getting a job. And the guy goes, I guess he starts whining. He's a 24-year-old man, and he starts whining. He's like, but Dad, you know I can't pass a piss test.
It's oh, like, my God.
Like, this is the, yeah. And it's like the whole segment is to make fun of millennials. But, like, this is real. You know, like, there are people out there who do this stuff. And it's just really, really sad. And please don't get that addicted. Don't be sitting on your computer or your console pooping yourself because you don't want to get up and go to the bathroom. You know you have an issue at that point. Use your common sense.
Oh, God, it reminds me of that South Park episode of the World of Warcraft one. I don't know if you've seen it.
Oh, God.
Where, like, Cartman's mom actually had a bucket in front of him and oh, my God. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That was, it reminds me of that. But most of the people who play, I mean, it's, they're acting like it's a huge epidemic. I mean, it is in China, obviously. But here, I mean, it's like, whatever. I don't think it's as big as it. Like, I never knew anyone that was just truly, well, actually, I did know one person who cut class in high school just to play League of Legends all day. And he ended up getting his GED because he flunked out of high school. But it's one of those, like, anomalies. Like, it doesn't happen as much as people say it does. You know, you see one article, but that's, like, one of the only times it actually happens. I don't know. Is it a huge epidemic? I mean, addiction, you can be addicted to anything. So to say video game addiction is an epidemic, I mean, yes and no. You can be addicted to literally anything. You see those shows of people addicted to eating couch cushions or whatever the hell you see on there. Like,
gross.
You can get addicted.
Oh, what was that called? My Strange Addiction?
Yeah, I remember that
show.
You can get addicted to anything, literally anything. So a lot of people play video games, so, you know, a lot of people end up getting addicted to it. But, you know, people get addicted to everything. You just, you know, gaming is more of a mental addiction than a physical addiction, like nicotine or, you know, like hard drugs, like meth. You know what I mean? So to compare those two things, I don't think it's very fair. And I don't know. I mean, it's definitely a problem, but I think that it's definitely exaggerated quite a bit.
Well, you also got to know whose fault it is. I mean, whose fault would you say? You have a family situation where a kid plays video games all day and does nothing else. Whose fault is that?
I would say the parents, but parents don't take responsibility anymore for their children.
No,
you know,
they
especially
don't.
When it comes to M-rated games. They say, oh, these games are too violent for kids. Well, don't buy you have to be present. Well, maybe not anymore because you have digital games. But you have to hand that kid your credit card for them to be able to buy the game. So if you're not supervising them,
and if you're
that's on
if
you.
If you're not going to your kid, what I would do, like PlayStation or Xbox, right? Don't link your card. Make your kid come to you and say, hey, I want this game. Here's what it is, and here's why I want it. Like, you will just be responsible, you know?
But even
you,
when
you
everything
have an obligation
was...
as a parent. And the thing that really annoys me, too, is you'll see these parents who are like, my kid just sits around and plays video games all day and does nothing else. It's the video game's fault.
So turn off
it's
their
like,
fucking
you need to take a
computer.
Look
turn off their computer. Or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I really don't understand. Like, you know, you don't want to take responsibility. You know, I get, you know, a lot of them work all day. I mean, if you have a 24-year-old, that's a whole different situation. You should just throw their ass out. But, you know, if you have like a 13, I've seen, you know, you've seen those 13-year-olds that are addicted to video games and do nothing but that. I played a lot of video games as a child, but if I had to do something like visit grandma or anything like that, like, I did it. You know what I mean? Or if I had to go to school, you know, because some of these kids cut school, and I'm thinking to myself, is it really the kid or is it no discipline from their parents? Because how many 13, 14-year-olds make rational decisions? Like, if you didn't have your parents around when you were in your teens, how well off do you think you would be today?
Oh, man, I would have learned from everyone at school, and that would have been awful. Like, that would have been the only coaching I had was everyone at school. Oh, man, that would have been terrible.
So I think we need to shift more of the blame to the parents or whoever is supposed to really be responsible for
the guardian
for their well-being, not EA or whatever company. You know, there's always a joke saying that, you know, the kid's Xbox is their babysitter because, you know, they're too busy doing whatever than actually spending time with their children and, you know, taking on the responsibility of being a parent. So
I remember I knew this kid. It was my best friend's younger brother, and I would go over to their house all the time, and I'd be like, hey, do you want to go outside and play some airsoft with me and your brother, your big brother? And he's like, no, I'm playing video games. Like, we would actually force him to go outside all the time. We had to do that with my brother every so often. I mean, it's easy to fall into it and not realize that you're in trouble. But like, if you know someone who's like even on the verge of that, you gotta fix that fast because that can get out of control.
Like
what we just said, they could die. That would be on your conscience.
I mean, me personally, I do put plenty of hours into video games, but if someone's like, hey, do you want to go out? Most of the time, I am not going to just, you know, sit home and play video games the entire day. The only time when I just decide, fuck it, I'm not going, this actually happened recently. It's like fucking 10 degrees outside, and I don't feel like going all the way out to like the other side of the city to do something I don't really even want to do. I think that's different. That's not really related to video games, though. That's just not wanting to do something. But, yeah, no. I mean, I think if you have a problem, it's easy to tell, and it's easy for the people around you to tell, and if they don't help you, then, you know, that's on them and that's on you. That's all I have to say about that situation. If you have anything else to say before we move on, you can say whatever about this topic.
No, I think I said my piece. I'm good.